prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sin. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, by whose gift your faithful offering you write the praiseworthy service, grant, we pray, that we may hasten without stumbling to receive the things you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Avoid getting into debt. Accept the debt of mutual love. If you love your fellow men, you have carried out your obligations. All the commandments: you shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and so on, are summed up in this single command: you must love your neighbour as yourself. Love is the one thing that cannot hurt your neighbour. That is why it is the answer to every one of the commandments. The word of the Lord. Happy the man who takes pity and lends. Happy the man who fears the Lord, who takes delight in his commands. His sons will be powerful on earth. The children of the upright are blessed. Happy the man who takes pity and lends. He is a light in the darkness for the upright. He is generous, merciful, and just. The good man takes pity and lends. He conducts his affairs with honour. Happy the man who takes pity and lends. Open-handed he gives to the poor. His justice stands firm forever. His head will be raised in glory. Happy the man who takes pity and lends. Alleluia, alleluia. Because of your love, give me life, and I will do your will. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with
you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Great crowds accompanied Jesus on his way, and he turned and spoke to them. If any man comes to me without hating his father, mother, wife, children, brothers, sisters, yes, and his own life too, he cannot be my disciple. Anyone who does not carry his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. And indeed, which of you here, intending to build a tower, would not first sit down and work out the cost to see if he had enough to complete it? Otherwise, if he laid the foundation and then found himself unable to finish the work, the onlookers would all start making fun of him and saying, "Here is a man who started to build but was unable to finish." Or again, what king marching to war against another king would not first sit down and consider whether, with 10,000 men, he could stand up to the other who advanced against him with 20,000. If not, then while the other king was still a long way off, he would send envoys to sue for peace. So in the same way, none of you can be my disciple unless he gives up all his possessions. The Gospel of the Lord. We hear those lovely words from St. Paul in his letter to the Romans this morning, telling us that all things that are not of God are not of love, and things that are of love are always of God. There is nothing that happens in this world. There is nothing bad that happens in this world as a result because of a lack of love. Love your neighbour as yourself. Love is the one thing that cannot hurt your neighbour. If only our world would truly live that commandment. Let us pray that the world will reach out and be a more loving and caring place.
So let us turn to the Lord with our prayers and petitions this day. We pray for the Church, that it may be a means in which people may see God's love, and also that God's people will live that love in their lives. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for our world, which is often lacking in love. We pray for peace where there is war, for justice where there is injustice. We pray that we may all play our own part in bringing about a more just society. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Pray for ourselves and our journeys of faith, that we may witness always to that love that Christ calls us to show. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick in mind or body. Pray for those who care for them, that they may be rewarded for their generosity and service. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who have died and those whose anniversaries occur at this time. Families who grieve and mourn, that they may be comforted. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We ask for the prayers of Mary, Mother of Christ, as we pray to you.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
We make these and all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given, which human hands have made, before you come for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Amen.
May these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, become for you a pure oblation, for us the holy outpouring of your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holiness as gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve you. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Mary Magdalene, for whom we offer this Mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours for ever and ever.
Amen.
The Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth,
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
pray together an act of spiritual communion. Join with those who are still able to attend Mass at this time. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since many cannot in this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into their hearts. We embrace you as if you were there, and unite ourselves over to you. Never permit us to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. May the working of your power, O Lord, increase in us, we pray, so that renewed by these heavenly sacraments, we may be prepared by your gift for receiving what they promise, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.